Hello, my name's Andy Maluzzi, and I built the LEGO Mindstorm Space Shuttle. The LEGO Mindstorm Space Shuttle is an interactive 1/50th scale model of the United States Space Shuttle built out of LEGO Mindstorms and LEGO Technic parts. The concept was originally designed back in October 2010 in a meeting in the Netherlands with LEGO, and we were thinking about cool projects that we could come up with. Following that discussion, we put together some plans and broke down the project into some manageable pieces, and in January 2011, we began construction on the model you see behind me. The model was built by three people. I built the orbiter, so the main body of the space shuttle. A friend of mine who lives in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, named Marc-André Bezaghetti, he built the Canadian robotic arm, and another friend of mine, John Brost, who lives in Indiana, built the stand for the space shuttle and also made the nameplate. The shuttle integrates four NXT controllers, all talking together. So they're actually talking over RS485, which is an industrial communications protocol. The NXT has native support for it, but did not have the firmware or the easy programming experience. So I actually went into the firmware, found out how to use it, how to make the calls, and then actually made LabVIEW VIs and also ported to the NXTG software over there so that any 8-year-old could now use industrial communication in their designs. The software is available for free download off my website, 08maluz.wordpress.com. In addition to that, the shuttle has 11 different motors actuating everything from the Canadian arm to the cargo bay doors to the ailerons and also tilting it side to side. It leverages 12 sensors that can detect everything from when someone walks by and will resume it moving to the tilt, ensuring that it will not fall over. To also using different check sensors to make sure the doors are closed. To show those sensors, we have a LabVIEW front panel up there that's actually getting the real-time data from all those sensors and seeing the processing that the system is doing to control the shuttle in an autonomous mode. In a little bit more interactive mode, it can be remote-controlled, and those same sensors then act to ensure that the user does not actually crash the shuttle, either crashing the arm into someone or tipping it over. That's it.